Now, how about the local situation? What's going on here in the Monterey Bay region? Well, the answer is pretty darn good. Look, employment's in record level, over 140,000 payroll jobs in Monterey, okay, close to 105,000 in Santa Cruz. Growth in Santa Cruz, about 3% Monterey, same sort of number. What kind of job? The broad mix. About construction, though, some of the fastest growing in both counties, because yes, there's a pickup in things there. Manufacturing is doing great, Monterey's picking up. Good growth in professional business services, government's picking up. Good solid numbers here over in Santa Cruz. The government's moving forward. Services, education, health. Good solid numbers. You see growth across the region. San Bernardino, we got a little less data on because it's such a small economy. But there again, you're seeing payroll jobs continue to move forward about 14,500 now. And of course, the growth rates we have in the third quarter show a little not quite as strong growth there as other places. But again, construction, manufacturing, professional moving forward very nicely right now. And wages for work people who work here rising across the board as well. Some very solid numbers. You know, you've got nothing out there but good things happening. And look at some of the drivers. Tourism and sales. Hotels here are actually seeing the biggest burst. There's been some cooling in the San Francisco Peninsula region, but now you look at the rising rates and you look at the occupancy rates coming up in the region. That's a big driver. People are coming back here. You look at year-to-year growth in tax and sales, it's re-accelerated again for the three economy region. Solid numbers there. Venture capital in Santa Cruz is booming again. I did a tech report for that county not too long ago. Came up here to that tech meetup in Santa Cruz, just down the road here. A lot of fun. You can see all the new companies coming in to the region. Lots of good stuff there. Real ag output. 2016 was a record year for ag output in Monterey. In fact, that brings me to the only bad thing that's happening as well. It was a record year for output, crop values fell. Because, of course, there's all the big collapse in prices. And so, it's not that there's not a lot of stuff going on out there. It just got hit by that commodity wave. And, of course, recently, ag employment has dropped. In fact, on a year-to-year basis, ag employment has dropped about 5% here in Monterey County. But that number may not have everything to do with prices. In fact, I'm going to go to probably the most important statistic of all, and that's the unemployment rate in the region here. Santa Cruz, record, almost a record low. It was only lower back in 2000. San Bernardino, record low. Monterey, record low. So record low unemployment, just like the rest of the state. You're running out of people. You're running out of people who work to work. And as a result of that, as good as the payroll numbers are now, it's pretty clear it's going to slow down because of a sheer lack of availability. And of course, again, unemployment rates, those low employers have benefits, wages are rising. Look at the numbers. The big share of increases of households earning over 100,000 per year. Santa Cruz up 5.6 percentage points. In Monterey at 4.5 percentage points. Declines in low income, the number of low income households. You can see a lot of folks getting ahead of the curve in this particular situation. Some very solid numbers there. But the labor force constraints are going to start kicking in. Labor force growth over the last couple of years is not even averaging 1% or so. A very little, and that of course goes back to population growth. The population growth is limited because of a lack of new housing. Look across, vacancy rates incredibly low. A number of new permits, while it has bounced, there is some sign of life there. Overall, number of new permits, running about 200 for the three county region, running a little over 200 per quarter. You're not even 1,000 per year. That's a third, a half to a third of what it was back in the latter part of a decade. More housing is so desperately needed. And that's why prices are going up so much. That's why rents are going up. A sheer lack of supply. And we understand all the reasons why. But supply of housing is such a critical element to growth in this state right now. And yeah, the region needs to think long and hard about this. I understand some changes are involved there. But land use policy is probably the most critical conversation we should be having in the state of California. What you need to be having is this three county region as well. Unfortunately, land use conversations really aren't happening at all. And it's becoming particularly problematic given this. Because when you look at Santa Cruz and North Monterey and San Benito, you have to understand these are all in the commute shed of that economic powerhouse called the Bay Area, an area that is similarly way behind on the production of new housing. And it's not insignificant. Overall, you're talking about from the three county region, you're talking number of people, particularly if we're going into Santa Clara County on a daily basis for work. That's going to continue because that economy continues to grow and there's no more housing. And so not only are your local businesses fighting to find workers who are fighting to find housing, but you now have to compete for that limited housing stock on the basis of the commuters. And it's a problem. It's a big problem for an economy that should have all burners firing, but you're being held back by this critical issue, a critical issue that truly hasn't been addressed. Which brings me to my initial point, which is about having the right conversations. The great problem, what we worry about versus what we should be worried about. Every time you roll out any kind of policy at the federal state level, jobs, forget that. You gotta worry about the number of workers. Or here in California, stop saying jobs, start saying roots. Which sounds a lot of fun at me. I'm working great. Roots. No? Who pays for health care versus what are we paying for? Why do we pay over twice as much as Japan when, by the way, Japan has better health care than we do? Why? Not fighting over who pays for it. What the hell are we paying for? We worry about tax levels, we worry about tax structure, we worry about income inequality, we worry about wealth inequality, we worry about funding government liabilities, we should worry about unfunding government liabilities. We worry about business investment, we should worry about lack of public investment. We worry about inflation, we should worry about slowing lending. Here in the state, we worry about the cost of California housing, we need to worry about the supply of California housing. We're in a school, and I bet you every teacher here understands this basic thing. If you don't ask the right question, you're never gonna get the right answer. So you gotta watch out for the weapons of mass distraction. Watch out for the nonsense. Start making our elected leaders focus on the real questions. Because once you do that, honestly, the answers aren't that hard. Thank you very much.